Hi everyone, today I am going to create a mixed media pencil case. So I will be using this stone paper by Stamperia, which is great because you cannot tear it, but you can do tons of other techniques on it. So first of all, I am going to use my paper trimmer and cut out two identical pieces. Both my pieces are 9 by 6 inches and you can see on screen the measurements in inches and centimeters as well. So I am going to treat both of these in the same way, and I am going to start by spraying all over my surface by using my mixed media aqua color. This is by Stamperia and it has a nice shimmer. I have used warm yellow and turquoise, and you can see that I can mix everything with my fingers. So you can see that the stone paper doesn't instantly absorb all that paint. I'm using my heat gun to speed up the drying process, and I have also blotted all the excess spray ink by using a paper towel. By the way, this is a baby wipe, so you can see that all those aqua color sprays are actually permanent, and that's great for the project that I'm going for. So I am doing the exact same process on the second piece of stone paper. Now I have two identical ones, and on the back I'm just going to cover it up with some acrylic paint. So you can see that you can do tons of techniques on this paper, including spraying and applying acrylics. I am just going to cover up the back. This is going to be the inside of my pouch, so I don't really care of how this is going to look. Now for the outside, I am going to stamp, and I'm using my black ink. I'm just going to stamp a couple of designs just to make it look more interesting. So you can see that you can even stamp on this stone paper. And now let's move on to another technique. You can even use your modeling paste over this paper. And I am going to use my Stamperia modeling paste and apply just a little bit with my spatula. I'm not going heavily over the stencil, but I am applying randomly through that a nice stencil with all those dots. All the supplies that I'm using today are by Stamperia, which is an Italian company, and you can find the full list of supplies just below the video in the description area as well as on my blog. Now the other piece of stone paper, instead of doing only the dots, I am also going to use this stencil and stencil the words inspire and creative. Now instead of doing creative, I am going to stop at the letter T, and then I am going to stencil only the letter E so I can create the word create instead of creative. So once I'm happy with that, I'm going to peel off, and I am going to use a baby wipe, and you can see how easy it is to wipe off areas that I don't like. And at this stage, you can see how important it is that the sprays were actually permanent. So now I'm going to stencil the letter E. And just to make this piece look similar with the other side, I'm going to do some stenciling over that stencil with the dots. What is great about this modeling paste is that when it dries, it doesn't crack no matter how much you manipulate that paper. And you will see that I'll do lots of manipulation later on. So in case you want to have a flat bottom on your pencil case, then you can pencil out a square. I am using a 1.5 inches square here, only at the bottom, and I'm going to cut it out. So you can see that you can easily cut stone paper even with your scissors, although you cannot tear it with your fingers. Now I am going to do the same thing on the other side. Now let's move on to the zipper. I am using a nylon zipper, which is going to make our life easy since we can sew over it. Also the zipper, just to make the project super easy, is longer than the paper. Notice how I place the zipper upside down, and I'm going to sew along the top line. On my sewing machine, I am going to use my zipper foot. And if you are a beginner on sewing, then this is a great project for you. Just because this is stone paper, it stays nice and sturdy, and it doesn't stretch out just like many of the fabrics do. So everything is nice and straight here. And also, I'm not going to use any advanced techniques. This is going to be a super easy and totally for beginners sewing project. So I am not going to line up the pouch. And after all, you will see that it's going to look really nice at the end. So I have made sure that I have connected my paper with my zipper, and now I'm going to fold everything back and I'm going to top stitch. So this is going to make sure that the flap at the back is going to stay on its place. Again, I'm using my zipper foot and I'm top stitching. So you can see how it looks at the moment, and the flap is nicely secured at the back. Now I'm going to place the other side. Again, I'm making sure that it's nicely lined up. And you can pin if you want, or if you have those nice little clips, it's even easier. So again, I'm going to use my zipper foot and sew all along that line. And after that, you can see that I need again to do the top stitching. So I'm going to fold the flap at the back. You can even use your bone folder. You would, if that was a fabric project, you would use your iron. But since this is stone paper, just by finger pressing or by using your bone folder, that would be work perfectly fine. So now I'm doing my top stitching. And now I'm going to fold them, but make sure that you open up the zipper. So once everything is folded, I'm going to do both the sides and the bottom. So this is finished. You can see that I have already sewn around. And now I can open up the two bottom holes, and I'm going to bring them together. So in this way, I am going to create the flat bottom. You can totally skip that, and instead of cutting out those squares at the bottom, you can just leave them, those rectangled pieces, as they were, and then you will end up with a rectangle pouch, pencil case, that doesn't have a flat bottom. So you can, this is the pouch, and it's actually finished at this stage. You can use scissors to cut out the seam allowance, but I'm not really bothered about them. I'm just going to leave them as they are. And now I'm going to put inside out all the pencil case, and you can see how much I manipulate the paper, but it doesn't tear no matter what I do. So it really is a sturdy pencil case. You can use your bone folder to help you while you are trying to push out all those corners. And the pouch is pretty much finished. All I have to do now is to make sure that all the corners are nicely straight out. And as you manipulate the paper, you will find out that it gets softer and softer. Now I am also going to use my scissors to cut out the excess of the zipper. And my pouch is ready. I just love my new pencil case, and I really love that it looks like if I have designed my own fabric line. Now you can see that I can fit in lots of stuff inside, and you can always make them bigger or smaller depending on how big you are going to cut out the starting rectangles. So that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the project today. And if you need more inspiration, here are a couple of my older mixed media projects. Thank you all for watching!